You've heard the stories about co-workers who go to court to fight over lottery winnings, or how hell hath no fury, like the guy left out of the lucky office pool. Well, this is not one of those stories. In fact, this is the kind of story that can make you reevaluate the common decency of your cubicle mates and whether it's a job worth going back to after a big lottery win or even a crushing loss. Here's ABC's Steve Osunsami.
The glory of instant wealth, the flashing cameras, the dream of holding one of those larger-than-life checks. Even with the lottery odds against us, millions of people can't stop dreaming that impossible dream.
All right, you're in the $10 pool?
Yep.
All right.
Or thinking they might actually better their chances by banding together and playing in an office lottery pool. That's what these happy coworkers did at Keller Williams Realty in Plantation, Florida.
I want some of this luck.
I hope you've got those tickets. Good luck.
And they struck it rich over the weekend, winning big in Powerball.
Powerball winner.
But here's where the ultimate dream come true quickly turned into a potential nightmare. Office coordinator Jennifer Maldonado was all out of cash that day and decided to sit this one out.
I felt like, you know, maybe it wasn't the smartest thing for me to do to spend my money on lotto when I have a lot of other things that need to be accounted for.
She was the new face in the office, just hired, and hadn't even gotten her first paycheck.
This is my third week.
Lori Finkelstein-Reeder, who organized the pool, even offered to spot Jennifer the cash, and she still said no.
I said to her, quote, Jen, if you don't play, we're going to win.
You're welcome.
But when the numbers rolled by on Saturday night, one of the tickets everyone else pitched in on matched five numbers.
We're going to round it out tonight with the number 31.
Enough to win the group $1 million. It looked like it was tough luck for Jennifer.
I was upset with myself that already I was new, and now this would put me on the outside even further.
And if recent history is a guide, when you mix office politics in a winning ticket, things can get messy. Back in February, seven Indianapolis hairstylists took their coworker to court after they said she claimed a $9 million winning ticket for herself. Then there's the case of Americo Lopez, a construction worker from New Jersey. A couple years back, he bought the tickets for his fellow construction workers. But when he stopped showing up at work, the others soon found out they had actually won a $38 million jackpot. Lopez claimed he bought the winning ticket on his own, but his coworkers sued for their fair share and won. These overnight riches can spoil office friendships in a flash, like Jennifer Habib's California hospital pool, nicknamed the Lucky Seven. They took home one of the biggest jackpots in U.S. history, $20 million apiece. But the aftermath was nothing like those happy lotto ads. Some hospital colleagues who joined the pool in the past thought they should have shared the cash and took their coworkers to court.
That caught us all off guard.
For a while in our office, it was a standing joke, okay, who sued the Lucky Seven today? Because people kept coming out of the woodwork.
They successfully fought off the challenges, but all those hard feelings made for some ugly days at work.
It's another set of problems bigger than what you may have had in your life before.
I think people that work together and are friendly just don't think maybe ahead of time of what could go wrong.
Thankfully for Jennifer Maldonado, the new hire at Keller Williams, things never got uncomfortable. Even though she decided to pass on the office pool, she was lucky enough to have these generous colleagues willing to count her in. 12 of them will take home $83,000 apiece after taxes, and they've all decided to give Maldonado a portion of their winnings, but wouldn't say exactly how much.
A gracious amount.
But Carol Hettinger of the New Jersey Lottery has some advice for anyone else joining a similar office pool. Sign a basic contract outlining the rules and find a trustworthy, well-organized leader.
If you have in writing who are the members of the pool and how much money they've put in, if you have copies of the tickets before the draw, if you know where the tickets were purchased and when, you've got an ironclad case.
That leader has to promise not to buy any personal tickets outside the pool unless they let others know first. Set a deadline for collecting cash. Figure out who holds the tickets and where. And decide in advance what to do if a coworker can't contribute that week. Good advice for future lotto pools at the real estate office in Florida, where they've already decided how they'll spend the money.
Down payment on a home for my husband and I.
Donate some to charity. Buy a new car.
I'm going to Disney World.
And Jen Maldonado says next time she's definitely in from the start. And with the kind of luck they have here, so am I.
I'm going to be in your next pool. So here's my 20, and I'm leaving you my card with all of my contact information.
For Nightline, I'm Steve Osunsami in Plantation, Florida.